Today's Tuesday tip is part two of getting the dirt on your soil. Reviewing the soil test report and decide what corrective actions might need to be taken. Hi, I'm Brad with the University of Missouri Extension Master Gardener of Greater Kansas City. So let's take a look at Joel's soil test report. In part one, we demonstrated taking the soil sample. Today, we're going to review the soil test report, then determine what corrective action steps are needed. So let's get started. First, let's look at the soil pH. Soil pH is a measure of the acidity or alkalinity of the soil. A pH of 7 is neutral. Less than 7 is acid, and greater than 7 is alkaline. Most of the essential plant nutrients are available at optimum levels between a pH of 6 and 7. The soil pH at 6.5 on this test report is optimal, so we don't need to add any chemicals or amendments. Next, we'll look at the phosphorus level, which is designated with the letter P. Phosphorus is important for root growth and plant development. This lawn has more than adequate phosphorus for this important soil function. The next element we're going to look at is potassium, and it's designated by the letter K. Potassium helps the lawn develop its growth and stress tolerance. And we all know how stressed a Midwestern lawn is from spring to fall with heat, drought, and even diseases. So as we see from the test report, the potassium level is more than adequate, so nothing needed here. Other vital elements to the soil are calcium, designated as Ca, and magnesium, designated as Mg. These elements help with the plant's development and healthy growth. Again, the soil test report shows good levels, so no amendments needed. Organic matter is another important item of soil health, as it helps with water and nutrient retention. Simply put, organic matter is all the stuff in the soil, such as plant residue, microbes, and decomposing matter. The 8.2% is excellent. If this was low, less than 3%, then an easy way to correct this would be to not bag your lawn clippings. Now, we get a little more technical, and a good reason to have a lab do a soil analysis, the cation exchange capacity, or CEC. CEC is a measure of your soil's capacity to hold nutrients, specifically positively charged ions such as potassium, calcium, and magnesium. Soils with high CEC will retain nutrients better than low CEC soils. A range between 12 to 25 is considered typical. Here again, the lawn is within parameters. Last, we look at the fertilizer and limestone recommendations. Here we see various chemicals contained in fertilizers and how much to apply in pounds per 1,000 square feet. The only recommendation from the soil test report is to apply nitrogen at a level of 3 pounds per 1,000 square feet for the fescue, blue, and ryegrass lawns. Nitrogen promotes healthy leaf growth and is critical for the lawn to produce chlorophyll and enhances photosynthesis. So, what do we do next? We'll determine the square footage of the lawn. Concerning Joel's lawn, we have a nitrogen amendment recommendation. So, he will have to buy a fertilizer with high nitrogen. This fertilizer has a guaranteed analysis of 24-0-4. Now, how much fertilizer do we need to apply to get the recommended 3 pounds of nitrogen per 1,000 square feet? We measured our backyard area, and it is actually close to 1,000 square feet. The fertilizer bag weighs 50 pounds with the guaranteed analysis of 24% nitrogen. Of the 50 pounds, the nitrogen element in the fertilizer bag makes up 24% or 12 pounds. Since our soil test indicates that we needed 3 pounds of nitrogen per 1,000 square feet, you will need to apply approximately 25% of the bag or 12.5 pounds of fertilizer to your 1,000 square foot lawn. Follow the manufacturer's recommendations on the bag for spreader application settings. The University of Missouri Extension has a lawn fertilizer calculator to easily determine how many pounds of fertilizer you will need to apply. Links to spreader calibration and application times are also available on the website. After applying your fertilizer, be sure to blow or sweep any excess fertilizer off the streets, sidewalks, and driveways back into the lawn to protect our storm sewers and waterways. Store excess fertilizer in a cool, dry place and dispose of the fertilizer according to manufacturer guidelines. By doing a soil test and following the recommendations, you can avoid unnecessary costs, help the environment by limiting chemical usage, and have a lawn you can be proud of. We hope you enjoyed today's Tuesday tip. If you like our videos, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on our next video. And we will see you in the garden.
Volunteers from Master Gardeners of Greater Kansas City provide free, research-based answers to your yard, garden, and plant questions. Voicemail is active 24 hours for your convenience, or you can email your questions to the hotline. Normally, you will receive a response within 2 business days. So for any of your garden questions, call the hotline at 816-833-TREE. That's 816-833-8733. Or send your email to mggkc.hotline@gmail.com. More complete information can be found on our website at mggkc.org. And don't worry, all of this information is in the Show More section below.